The standstill agreement was supposed to be for 1 year, that is from 29th November 1947 to 28th November 1948. So it was 1 year period. But in this 1 year period, the Nizam and the Indian government developed a lot of differences. Both started accusing each other that you are violating the terms and conditions of the standstill agreement. The Nizam was blaming Indian government and the Indian government was blaming the Nizam. So this blame game was happening. And everybody knew that, you know, these are all well-planned tactics. But in July and August 48 onwards, the things in Hyderabad became so disturbed, according to the North Indian politicians and the Congress leaders, that they gave an ultimatum to the Nizam government that you control the Razakars, Menes, otherwise, you know, we will come and take care of them. So they issued a clear threat to the Nizam government. Nizam, in response, reacted saying that, you know, I am capable of controlling myself. You don't need to come to my area. But in the same period, many Hindus started migrating to the North Indian enclaves in the borders. So now the records say that the Congress and the other groups made a propaganda in the district borders that India is going to overtake them militarily. And in that case, the Razakars are going to kill you. So army is going to come soon. So you please vacate your homes and go to your relatives in the British area. So this panic created panic in the people, and they started migrating to the bordering areas. Yeah, Hindus basically. Yeah, because they think that, you know, Razakars are all Muslims. Because at that time the image was created such that Razakars were all Muslims. So Hindus were made to believe that, you know, Razakars are going to kill them once army enters. And this migration of people was used by the media in a very big way, saying that, you know, the law and order situation in Hyderabad has collapsed because of Razakars and because of the misadministration of Nizam. So the military intervention is the only solution. So this propaganda was created in the press. So as a result, soon after Jinnah died, Nizam, Indian government started mobilizing the military units to the border areas of the Nizam state. And when Jinnah died, I think he died on 11th of September. So the operation was Operation Polo, which was named for invading Hyderabad, was started. According to the records, this Operation Polo was planned much ahead. When the standstill agreement was signed, it was planned at the time only, it seems, because they felt, you know, there will be a time, you know, when Nizam doesn't agree to join Hyderabad, then we will take over through military. So that plan was already there. So according to that plan, the army units was shifted to the Nizam borders. So when the Jinnah died, then there was a encouragement in the Indian administration, thinking that, you know, now nobody will raise a voice for the Hyderabad. So immediately planned a attack on Hyderabad. So they attacked on Hyderabad from four different places. The biggest was from from Osmanabad area. The biggest units were stationed there. So they entered the Hyderabad area. And Nizam army was ill-equipped. It was not having any equipment. It slowly started withdrawing. Literally, Nizam's army, you know, did not fight any battle. So they started withdrawing. But it was only the Razakars who, for the sake of their lands, protecting their motherland, they came forward and fought this Indian army. And many hundreds of Razakars were brutally killed in that fight. And within a day or so, all the Razakar units which were there in the borders were dismantled. So the military units came to Hyderabad border on 17th of September. And 18th of September, the Hyderabad army surrendered to them. So this was the period that started from 12th September and ended on 18th September. But within this period, what happened in the border districts were extremely, you can't use the words, the extreme form of violence that has happened in those border districts. So the stories were such that, you know, the Indian army, which was there in the Kashmir area and which saw the communal riots of northern India after partition and massacres in the Punjab, were affected by those developments. So they were unhappy with the developments in the North India, and they have developed very strong feelings against Muslims. So when they entered in Hyderabad, they were having those emotions in their mind. So they started becoming, you know, very violent in Hyderabad, and the propaganda was about Razakar was such that, you know, they felt that, you know, Razakar should be trampled so that, you know, no law and order can be created, problem can be created in the future, because they were not scared of the Nizam's army, they were much scared of the Razakars. So they were quite strict to the Razakars. So when they entered into the border areas in the Usmanabad and those Nandedh districts, they felt that since these districts were big centers of Razakars, so this has to be punished. So they went to all the villages everywhere and in search of Razakars, and started a manhunt for the Razakars. And apart from this, the Congress supported anti-social elements were also came forward who were resident of those districts, as well as the people from the other border districts. They also entered in Hyderabad along with the army, and with a view of looting the places, they came with a clear agenda of looting the Hyderabad areas. So all these people, along with the army and with the support of the army, started created a massive campaign of killing and raping and looting and burning of all the places in those areas. And according to different reports at the time, like Wilford Cantwell Smith says that, you know, 10% of the Muslim population of Nizam state has been massacred. The paper which he has written in 1948 after visiting Hyderabad. And soon after the Sundalal committee report, which is still not made public, it gave even much more bigger figures. Their figures reach up to 2 lakh people's murder. So they went to different districts, different places, and inquired the people and met various people there, and for many months, and then found out, you know, what happened there. So according to their estimates, from 50,000 to 2 lakh people were murdered in those areas. And this was just the murders and the rapes and the looting and the torturing were separate. These were only the figures about the murders. So there's the completely black period of in Hyderabad's history, what has happened in that period by the Indian army and various other antisocial elements. So this was the completely terrible chapter in the history of Hyderabad. And till now, many of the Muslim families still remember the horrific incidents of those days.